You take your beer clean glass here with proper sanitation and drying techniques. It's gonna go at a 45 degree angle.
Check. JD may go broke if it takes you this long to pour a beer, though. You got it, you got it, you got it.
What the f? Megan, stop.
Shut it up. Put it back. Oh, you forgot to tell us how to turn it off.
Yeah, you didn't go, you didn't go through that.
What the f?
How's it going?
How are you?
Good. What are you two drinking tonight?
I heard about a hideaway.
Yeah, that one has a lemon vodka in it.
Perfect.
That
yeah, works. Let's go with that.
I'll do a Lynchburg lemonade.
Okay, you got it.
Yeah. Do they have menus?
No, all right.
Oh, yeah, and can we get a food menu too?
Yeah.
Food menu.
Now, why wouldn't she have brought them the menu naturally, right? Tried to sell the food.
Right, there should be a sequence of service. It doesn't seem like that exists.
Yep.
Thank you. This menu is overwhelming.
And the menus are very dirty, too.
Yeah, this.
Well, let's see how this is.
Yep.
Okay. Hmm.
Ooh.
That's really sour, yeah.
Ooh. She didn't like that.
Oy.
When you get a minute, can we grab some food from you?
Yeah, give me 1 second. I'll be right with you.
It's just one girl here?
Yeah, I guess so.
So he had his hands on the floor in the ship, and now he's holding the glasses like that.
Oy.
Look at his hands on the top of the glass. His palm was pressing against it.
Oh, there's one for himself, too.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, I have something's in my drink.
Something's in her drink.
No way.
Ew.
There's more.
Okay, I'm done.
No?
No, I'm done.
No? What are we thinking, ladies?
We want to share the hideaway mac and cheese, please.
All right. Anything else?
I want to try the Cuban.
Good
also.
Choice.
I'll do the Philly dog.
Okay.
And she's got floaties in her.
Got a few floaties here.
I don't know if it's pepper or
I'm going to make it for you.
Thank you.
It's okay.
Smile.
And what's Dwayne doing at the corner of the bar talking to those customers, not paying attention to anything?
Beautiful. Get it sold. Get her done.
There you go.
Thank you.
Actually, this is a bigger floaty.
That one's even bigger than it was before.
It's okay. I think I'm okay.
Look, it's another one with black stuff floating in it.
What is that?
Their ice machine could have mold in it. How safe is the food when you see particles like that in the drinks?
Was that one okay?
There's actually like a bigger floaty in that one.
Awesome. Perfect.
I don't know.
With the food?
I don't know.
Maybe it's from the ice. In like a plastic cup now. She's like, screw the glass.
Like, now she's checking.
I'm just scared.
At this point, I wouldn't have a whole lot of confidence in having any cocktails here.
Thank you. Third times.
Perfect.
Thanks.
Oh, yeah.
Much better.
Thank you. Does it taste better third time around?
It's not much better.
Cocktail menu?
No, we don't.
Can you make a mojito?
What's in a mojito? We don't have mint.
Oh, we don't have mint?
No mints? You gonna do a Manhattan?
We don't have any driver here.
Yeah, bitter?
Yeah, bitter. Yeah.
Did you, Bloody Mary?
Bloody Mary?
Fighting chance?
Yeah. What is she making?
Those are his recons.
It has been 15 years since I made
one. All right, thank you.
Strong?
Or very strong? Very strong. My God.
Can you succeed like that?
Thank
you. He didn't blend his Bloody Mary.
What do you think?
It's got kind of a tomato bisque quality to it. Can I try it?
Yeah, go for it. Might need crackers.
That is an interesting Bloody Mary. What do you feel like you're good at?
It's a beer or shot bar, sweetie. What would you like?
Not a beer or a shot.
What the hell?
I'm sorry. I'm striking out here.
I'm not a health inspector, but I'm pretty sure our
bartender is smoking at the bar.
Are you allowed to smoke a cigarette now touching glassware? Is that legal or not? It is not. You got to get control of this. Let's listen.
What's your best cocktail that you can make with what you got behind that bar?
You can make you a martini.
Make right. a martini? Let's absolutely, do I'll do
vodka
that. Let's do a vodka.
Do you want it dirty or no?
Yes. Yeah, let's make it dirty.
I think the real question is it dirty because of olive juice or because it's just filthy?
Wow.
Oh, my goodness. She's beautiful. Poking the olives with her hands.
Listen to me. You're fielding a losing team. Can you possibly win?
Leo and John tried to get quality high-end cocktails. They wound up with nothing but incompetency and failure the whole time they were here.
Hi. Welcome.
Hi.
How you guys doing?
Good, how are you?
Good, are you excited about open mic night?
Do you guys have a beer list by chance?
We do not.
I'll take my pee.
Do you have any shelter?
One.
Thank you. This is not my mic.
I guess it's open mic night.
I guess.
How about the foam? Look at this. Wow. No head on that beer at all. Right there is where half of their beer costs is. So that was probably 40% of that beer. Easy.
Mm-hmm. I have concerns about what we refer to as a beer clean glass, because you could tell by the way that it was poured and the lack of standing head that there's some residue from somewhere inside that glass.
I had a beer that was old. The characteristics of an IPA would be the hops would be there, and they weren't there. So that means the beer's old. They've fallen off.
Do you see any open mic stuff happening?
No.
This is the epitome of a bad bar promotion. You see, the worst thing you want to do is start something and then not get it going. Okay, so what is she making here? That's a Brood Mary, right? Bloody Mary mix, little hot sauce beer.
Yeah, a little spice, a little beer, a little Bloody Mary.
That pour was so clogged, she had to screw it off the bottle. Look at it go! Look at it, man, it chunked! It was so thick, it wouldn't even go through the pour, and then she had to squeeze.
Oh my gosh, if it is that chunky, then there must be something wrong with it. And the fact that you would see that as you're putting it in a drink and still serve that drink speaks to standards.
Unbelievable, right? Oh, so they keep a pitcher of water next to the tapper to rinse the foam. So they expect the foam.
It's status quo, I guess.
And there's Jim. He doesn't see the beer going down the drain. He doesn't see anything.
Oh my God.
What happened?
I don't know. I feel like it's
just. Do you not like release the pressure properly? Like it's so basic. Like, how do you not know how to pull the nozzle properly?
It wasn't my fault. It just was like foamy. And
that's why you need to pay attention, because if you would have done that properly, you would have sprayed everywhere. It wouldn't be an issue. You wouldn't be covered in beer. They wouldn't be covered in beer.
Jesus Christ.
Oh my God.
If they could quit bickering, they would be much better off. Chris is just completely unapproachable. She walks around with a scowl on her face. You know, these two are polar opposites.
The bartender's gone. She's singing. So that's good.
Woo-hoo! How are you guys doing tonight? All right, so welcome to Open Mic Night. This is my vision, but without you guys making this happen, it would definitely not happen. Chris is going to be performing one of my favorite songs that he does. It's called Turn It Up. Because the night is turning down, let's turn it up.
Okay, so this is starting to make sense now. So Kristen is the only one performing on Open Mic Night. So why do you think Open Mic Night exists?
Because Kristen needs a platform to showcase her talents.
The only thing I'm thinking of is you.
Take a risk, throw it down.
I'd kill the mic if it was me.
Oh. Now just turn it down, turn it up.
They're not even singing the same notes.
Turn it down. Woo. Yeah.
Wow.
Chris, could we get some beers?
Bottles?
Thank you.
He only drinks bottled beer in his bar.
Can you blame him?
Is this yours?
No, it was just here.
Sorry, you want to flip your phone for a second? I don't get anything on it. Yeah.
I can smell the pine salt. I'm enjoying.
The guys that come in here call it the chemical because we don't even know. I don't even know what that cleaner is.
Really?
It's like one of those bulk cleaners, so we put it in a spray bottle that's just like this. Like we just refill it. So my friend, he's like the chemical, like the cleaner. But I think it is pine salt, pretty much.
Wash your hands. Please wash your hands. Please.
Oh, she's not gonna wash.
Please wash your hands. You just handled chemicals, cleaning products.
The popcorn is being scooped out, and her hand is all over it.
The pitcher she's pouring is all foam right now.
Oh, wow.
It's beer. We're not reinventing the wheel here, John.
But that beer can cost 8 to 20 cents an ounce, and that's really expensive when it goes down the drain.
Absolutely.
And we just saw hundreds of ounces go down that drain.
I think they poured more than they served.
But night after night after night, has Jim done the math and said, you know, if I dump 3 beers every time I sell one, I can't make money.
His back is to the bar. He's oblivious to what's going on. His bar is hemorrhaging money, and he's got a Kool-Aid smile.
You know, this guy does not know the economics of beer. I'm gonna teach him. He needs to learn, doesn't he, Sean?
Good luck with that.
Here we go, Daniel.
Going down.
Scoot over, bitch.
Right.
Hi, guys. Can I get you guys something?
I want an orange cheese. Okay.
No?
Not enough tequila in that one. One up, one down. That has too much tequila in it. No! These two are now dead because they've sat here for 90 seconds waiting for you to top them. Make it one drink at a time. These guys are gonna go thirsty. Jess is gonna go broke. You guys are gonna go to the unemployment line.
I'm gonna save you the hassle.
One 1,000, two 1,000, done. Not the four to two. The first 10, 12, 15 drinks got dumped. They gotta work on their counts because everything is way too sweet.
Let's go, come on, move, guys.
Here we go.
Ship it, bring it. Hold that, the moment of truth. Sean?
Tastes like a sugar bomb.
Oh! They're not coming out that great right now.
You're looking at a 4 count.
I think the boys are getting a little irritated.
Who's actually gotten a drink? Raise your hand. One. One.
Oh my God.
One. How many have we dumped out?
I stopped counting at 20.
Get it right, guys. Let's go. Come on, get some drinks out of here.
We're buried. Bartenders aren't effective. If the employees don't get their systems together, Jesse's gonna fail.
It doesn't take a bar expert to tell you that something's wrong with these drinks. Both of my buckets are full. It's spilling over onto the bar. These guys can't get their counts right.
Ready to cry?
Yes.
We go! At about 80 cents an ounce, you made $5 on one drink and dumped hundreds down the drain. That is frickin' failure.
You guys can stay anywhere you like. Can I get y'all started with a drink or anything?
I want a hurricane.
You want the hurricane? I got you.
Everything 2, 3, 4 at a time. You with me?
Yes, sir.
Serve the whole bar.
And you want the hurricane?
Your hurricanes are way too sour.
Oh, boy, this is going to take all night. You're sitting in front of her, and you might be waiting 20 minutes.
Oh, my gosh.
Come on, girls. We got to go faster than this. We're going to be here all night.
Okay. These bartenders don't know how to stage, how to make 3, 4 drinks at the same time, set it up per tray. The kitchen doesn't know how to stage, how to drop the right items at the right time so food comes out. We're out of sync.
You feel comfortable serving that?
No, that's too sweet.
You would never say that.
Is that right?
Something doesn't look right.
No,
it's not. Where's the bucket? Dump it out. Let's do it again.
Let's go.
Let's go. Start right, guys. Come on. Look at this.
I'm trying.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This is where everybody's orders are. They're all sitting right here.
We're about 15 minutes in. We've lost it. Fact of the matter is, most of our guests don't have drinks. None of our guests have food yet. The orders are just going in. There's no organization here.
How are your drinks? What's wrong with it? Sour? Okay. I need two more hurricanes, not sour.
Where does this go?
Let me put the ticket there, man.
Go for it. Thank you.
Do not leave tickets here. You will get mixed up. Stab the ticket when you grab the food.
These are worse than the ones I just dumped? Yeah. Girls, these are the second drinks I'm dumping. So we've been about 15 minutes in, and the bucket's already halfway full. I believe there's more drinks in that bucket than there are out on the tables.
Send this back. Because so that way they'll know this. Tell them it ain't season.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
They said the drink needs more alcohol. They don't like it. It tastes like nut but juice. The seafood has no seasoning. It needs more butter.
Okay.
None of my customers are happy.
Well, we've waited 45 minutes, and my husband didn't even get a drink. They attempted to bring something out. It was cold, so we're just not happy tonight.
Come on, girls. It's another one. This is too tart, sweetheart. Way too sour. Drink's not balanced.
Please just say it's good.
Please.
Nope. I swear, I just want to walk out right now. This
more hurricanes in here than there are out in the restaurant.
Tony, this is how much your bartenders have dumped down the drain already.
They're talking about our liquor, bitch.
I know they're talking about our liquor.
I just want to cry.
There's more in here than there is in Guest Stands.
We're about 45 minutes. The room still isn't served. As rough as it is in here, you need to know it's worse at your bar. This is our waste so far tonight.
Hey, how are we doing today? Good. All right. Take a look at the menu. Let me know what you'd like, and I'll get started on that for you.
Oh, game on.
He said take their food order also. Could you do that?
Yeah, perfect.
Do you want me to put them in, or you got it?
Just go ahead.
So I'm going to just greet everybody.
Hi, how are you today, ladies?
Nice.
Beautiful. Perfect.
All right, here we go.
We're already taking drink and food orders, John.
Excellent.
Nice. Beautiful wash line. Perfect. Beautiful.
All right, you said both twice baked sweet potatoes and a lot of sweet pasta?
Yeah.
Got it. All right, for you.
If you can jump in this well and make a few.
I don't know them.
Well, you should. We did training.
Right.
I know you didn't get them. Well,
I want them to be accurate.
See what you can do. I'm behind you. What do you need?
I don't know.
What are you making?
All of these.
All of them.
Like.
All right, let's do the sweet potato cocktail first.
Okay.
That goes in the coop.
In the who?
The coop.
I don't know what that is.
You didn't doubt that.
System.
That is the coop.
It is.
Okay. Okay.
Travis.
Not the bar top, and that's not the way you hold the bottle.
Okay.
And that was not a 12 count.
That's what I said. I don't know these drinks. So would you like to help me here, or can I have the recipe?
I'm not allowed to help you.
She doesn't have a problem with it.
Why are you back here?
I'm here to help.
She will tell you what to do, but you have to do it. Let's go.
Jesus Christ, this is a goddamn nightmare.
Look, you did it.
All the way around.
No, that's fine.
That's good?
It's great. And she's going to back you up as soon as she's caught up.
She's not going to be caught up. I mean...
Well, we can't with that attitude.
Okay. So now what?
You're not even trying. I don't know. What else do you need to make?
All these drinks.
Well, then start making them.
I don't know how to.
You made that drink because she told you what to do.
Correct.
Are you going to learn if you don't do it?
I learn by doing. So next time I'll probably know how to
do that. So why don't you continue to do it, and she'll continue to coach you, and you'll continue to learn.
She's not a good coach, though.
Oh, she's a very good coach.
Okay.
Your attitude stinks, to be honest with you.
It does.
Try a little harder, and maybe you'll succeed.
Maybe so.
Give it a shot. What do you say?
No, I'm good. I'm good.
She's not going to give it a shot.
Nah.
So this is your team. She's not even going to try. Look at her, our hero.
Let her be the hero.
She has a wonderful attitude.
Yep.
Her attitude stinks.
Let her.
So it's not us, it's her. Sure you are. So get your attitude together or leave.
Bye-bye.
She's been miserable all day.
Bullshit, man. Shit.
So guys, I wanted to get us a good local perspective on this place. So I got three industry professionals. They're bartenders and servers. They know Atlanta and they know the business.
John's spies enter Barlow's, a 5,200 square foot space with 12 beers on tap, a circular main bar where smoking is permitted, and a non-smoking section separated by a glass partition.
Look at this partition they put up between the main bar and one of the side dining rooms. If you're a non-smoker, you have to go into that side room. If you're a smoker, you stay in the main room. Would you want to go to that bar and hang behind that glass and be separated from everybody else?
No.
No, absolutely not.
It's a big giant waste of space right now.
No check and I have to drain?
There's Jamie, bartender.
Schmidix.
Schmidix, for you?
Old fashioned, please.
Old fashioned.
Look at the foam, Russell. The beer is warm. You can see the way it comes out.
Yeah, it's waste.
You know it's not the temperature just by looking at it.
That's right here. Oh my God.
You're so warm, I'm surprised it didn't melt the glass.
Let's talk about your beer, guys. How much of that is foam? Do you know the reason why?
It's too hot.
It's too hot.
That's why I duct taped it.
You duct taped it.
See what temperature we got here. It's about 45 degrees. It should be about 36. When beer runs over 38 degrees, we get about 60% out of the keg, rather than 95%, so we lose our money right away.
When's the last time you actually cleaned out the bottom of this beer cooler? The whole bottom of this thing is like rotted out. You see all that? You know what that is? It's like stale, gross beer.
Oh no, here it is, guys.
Oh.
You know what that is? That is bacteria. Look at this, guys. It's solid matter. This will get people sick. How many times do you guys see that and not do anything about it? I'd like you guys to come back here and start cleaning up, okay?
Okay.
So for recon tonight, there's Lori, JT, and there's John. JT is a draft beer professional. Lori works in bars, and John knows the area really well. So we should get a good local and professional perspective on what's going on here.
John's recon team enters the end zone. A 4,200 square foot space featuring a U-shaped bar with 16 beers on tap, two service wells, and an empty stage.
What are we having today?
I'll take beer.
Okay.
The bar is disorganized and dirty.
And there's bottle caps everywhere, straws.
Look at that floor. That sticky walk sound.
This doesn't taste good.
That's not good. Sour.
The system must not be regulated properly.
They probably don't clean their lines.
You know what? Can I swap these out? It's just, they taste a little sour, flat.
Okay.
If you don't have great beer in a sports environment, you have nothing. Okay. Let's take a peek in the walk-in, and we'll see exactly what's happening here. What's all over that beer case?
Blood.
Look at the blood. It's dripping down all over your cases of beer. This is one of the most cross-contaminated kitchens I have ever seen.
Clearly, we've got some really bad lines here. You can see the color difference. This is filthy. It's gonna taste horrible.
I wanna go see the rest of the bar.
You guys got fruit flies everywhere.
Yeah.
If you don't clean every day, gestation period on a fruit fly is 24 hours.
We clean, smackly, we don't get nothing.
No, I'm sorry, you don't.
What's going on here?
Jesus, please don't tell me you guys are bartending with standing water behind the bar.
Look at the dirt in that water.
Do you guys give a
So there it is, the Los Angeles Brewing Company. And that little tiny sign, does anything catch your eye?
No. So it says 100 true beers on tap.
If they had 100 beers on tap and they were losing 15,000 a month, would you think that beer would be fresh?
No.
John and Maria stake out the Los Angeles Brewing Company, a 7,000 square foot bar featuring a glass countertop, full service kitchen, and 100 tap brew system missing over 80% of its tap handles.
Great that he has all this space. He's just gonna do something with it.
They don't even use these taps. They're wrapped in plastic wrap. That's the first part of the bar that you see.
It doesn't feel like an operational bar.
Okay, let's go do this.
Yeah.
Tonight for recon, I got Maria Menounos and I to go in together. Maria knows me well. She knows what I'm looking for, and she loves beer.
Hi, guys.
Hey, good. How are you?
Here's your beer list, and back of it is your food list, okay?
Thank you.
I've never seen so much empty space in a bar in my life, or a bar where I felt like I had to whisper. Yeah, seriously, right?
Do you brew your own beer here?
No, we don't.
You don't? So you're not a brew house.
Right.
Because you're called a brewing company. I'm trying to figure this out.
How many beers do you actually have?
believe I've had. I'm just kind of, you know.
The sign says you have 100.
Right, right.
Give me one of those for now.
Okay. We have 5 types of wings. Do you want me to order each one of them?
Yep.
Okay.
We'll see if it's cold and if it's right. Is that the way a beer should look when you serve it? You didn't pour the beer correctly because it has no head on it. Most of the flavor comes from the head of a beer, but the glass is so dirty that the head wouldn't formulate in the first place. So let's see if you can pour me one correctly. Try it again.
Well, okay. All right, let's try round 2.
That's more like it.
You all right?
Oh my God. My first beer in there was really nasty and bitter. It was kind of a no-win situation in the liquor department there.
Something has to be wrong with their draft beer system. This bar's all about beer, so I brought in just the right expert.
See what you get out? Got some brown stuff on that one there.
And you can smell it.
This is symptomatic of the lines not being cleaned.
Every beer distributor cleans their lines where their beer is at.
Do you know when your lines were cleaned last?
They were cleaned Monday.
They were cleaned Monday?
No way. Is that clean?
No.
You don't verify anything. You can't even get 2 inches of chrome clean. I see now why you want to sell the place. Let's go see the beer cooler. Last night, Maria spit out her beer, and the customers are saying that it's flat. So today, I want Neil to go through the beer system top to bottom.
Look at that. That's mold. White, bloomy mold. All that stuff's going right into your beer lines. Is anybody even checking on this? I mean, you gotta validate this stuff. There's obvious signs of neglect in the system. There's mold growing down there. Richard needs to learn more about his draft system in order to serve the best beer he possibly can.
We got a lot of work to do. We gotta have to replace some of these lines and rotate kegs, of course. Let's go up to the kitchen, okay? No liquor license. Strictly beer and wine. We have no kitchen. Look at this place. And look at that green color, my gosh. Dated. Look at the records above the bar. Wow. Nat, why are there records on the wall? What is this place? I don't think that it knows. This is a beer bar. So I wanted to bring some beer professionals in. So I have 2 brewers from Laverne Brewing Company, which is a great local brewery here in town. They know beer quality, and they know the marketplace. I'm curious to hear what they think.
Hi. Welcome.
Hi.
How are you guys doing?
Good, how are you?
Good, are you excited about open mic night?
Do you guys have a beer list by chance?
We do not.
I'll take my beer.
Do you have any stouts?
1.
Thank you. This is not my place.
I guess it's open mic night.
I guess.
How about the foam? Look at this. Wow. No head on that beer at all. Right there is where half of their beer costs is. So that was probably 40% of that beer. Easy.
Mm-hmm. I have concerns about what we refer to as a beer clean glass, because you could tell by the way that it was poured and the lack of standing head that there's some residue from somewhere inside that glass.
I had a beer that was old. The characteristics of an IPA would be the hops would be there, and they weren't there. So that means the beer's old. They've fallen off.
Okay, so what is she making there? That's a Brood Mary, right? Bloody Mary mix, little hot sauce beer.
Yeah, little spice, little beer, little Bloody Mary.
That pour was so clogged, she had to screw it off the bottle. Look at it, Oh, man, it chunks. It was so thick, it wouldn't even go through the pour, but then she had to squeeze.
Oh my gosh, if it is that chunky, then there must be something wrong with it. And the fact that you would see that as you're putting it in a drink and still serve that drink speaks to standards.
Unbelievable, right? Oh, so they keep a pitcher of water next to the tapper to rinse the foam. So they expect the foam.
It's status quo, I guess.
And there's Jim. He doesn't see the beer going down the drain. He doesn't see anything.
Oh my God.
What happened?
I don't know. I feel like it's
just. Do you not like release the pressure properly? Like it's so basic. Like, how do you not know how to pull the nozzle properly?
It wasn't my fault. It just was like foamy. And
that's why you need to pay attention, because if you would have done that properly, you would have sprayed everywhere.
be an issue. You want to be covered in beer? They want to be covered in beer.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, my God.
Jon is joined in the SUV by Steve Blovat, a professional health inspector.
So I've had this place under surveillance for 3 days. The reason why I wanted you to come here is because I think this might be the worst kitchen I've ever seen. Open ceiling. Look at the bugs.
Disgusting.
Now this is a grease opportunity.
What owner makes their employees work in these conditions?
They don't care.
Stinks. Brian and Phil enter Fairways, a 6,000 square foot space featuring a short L-shaped bar with a single service station, 20 beer taps, and a large kitchen with two walk-in coolers.
Could you pour me a darkest beer?
Absolutely.
There are bugs in the bar too.
It's just pouring properly, right off the top.
And the keg is canceled.
We don't have another keg.
Are you kidding me?
You don't have another keg.
Mm-mm.
Look, everything goes in frosted white, and then look at the overpour. Holy f***.
The first thing that hit my tongue was a very, very hard metallic taste.
Oh, dude, that's bad.
Right when it hit the bottom of my stomach, I knew something was wrong. My stomach started curdling. Beer starts to go bad after around 3 months. So I'm thinking the keg had to have been sitting there for at least a year.
So here comes the food for Chef Duffy.
We got some chips and queso and some chips and salsa. Fried mushrooms.
Fried mushrooms, very nice.
Hey, Michelle, do you have a bathroom?
Do we have a bathroom?
Where's your bathroom?
Right back there to the left.
Dude, I think this might come up right now.
Fairways burgers.
Three fairways, medium.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Just so you know, medium doesn't bleed, so I got bloody medium. You guys make your own salsa in-house?
We do.
You do. Oh my God, he threw up. Caitlin, did you see where my buddy went by chance?
Here's I'll go check. For me.
Thank you very much. I think you got my boy sick.
I made him sick.
One sip of beer made this guy throw up.
Dude's throwing up.
Do what?
Dude's throwing up in the bathroom.
Off of what?
I don't know. We took out the chips and salsa and stuff, and now he's throwing up.
Oh, that's what's wrong with salsa? Ain't nothing wrong with salsa.
Kevin's an excellent cook. His focus on making great food, I think he can be an excellent asset.
You've done this for 14 years?
Never seen anything like this before. This is ridiculous.
This guy should be shut the hell down. Let's go in there.
You almost killed my frickin' mixologist. Phil is in the bathroom throwing up right now.
Off beer?
Yes! Off beer, for Christ's sakes! This is Steve. He's a health inspector with me. In 14 years, have you ever seen somebody throw up so quickly from consuming something?
Absolutely not.
What just happened, Phil?
Just puking my brains out, because I drank that right there. Take a sip of it, man.
Go ahead, you let your customers drink it, drink it.
Taste it.
Must be 86.
Supposed to be 86. Is it connected? Does she know it's 86, did you?
No, sir.
You won't drink it, but he will.
What did they order? A margarita?
Margarita and a cosmopolitan.
This is probably the worst Cosmo I've ever had in my whole entire life.
That Cosmo looks like a glass of strawberry jam. Look at the color of that thing.
I'm sure that's how she wanted to get that Cosmo, too, is in a rocks glass.
Well, kick there, huh?
When I order a shot of tequila, I don't drink it in a wine glass.
That's right.
This is seriously not good at all.
These guys do not know how to pour liquor. They are selling a bunch of beer. Understand his staff is going to cause him to lose it all? Look at what they're doing.
This is ridiculous.
Oh! I've never seen this type of employee interaction in front of customers before.
I mean, literally behind the bar.
It's a joke.
They're causing him to fail. I want each one of these employees to realize how out of line their behavior is. Then I got to start building Jeff. He needs to start acting like an owner.
I wasn't sure if you were going to even be here or not. So what happened, Randy? You going to enable him to keep acting that way? Is that what you're doing? How about letting him stand up and be a man on his own?
I'm here for Jeff and this bar.
Were you last night?
Yeah.
You were.
You're freaking drunk! You need to listen to him.
Kiss his ass, f*** it.
And that's how I'm treating you, until you prove to me otherwise.
No excuse for my behavior. I apologize. I love this place. I love Jeff. I want this place to be good for Jeff. Prove that I'm worth keeping.
What does it do for your million one when they drink in this building?
Flush it down the toilet.
Who's allowed to drink in this building from now on?
Nobody.
Nobody. There is no option. Kimmy.
You need to get your attitude better, don't you? What are you going to do to change that?
I'm going to lose it.
Talk to me. What don't I know that's making you say that?
I shouldn't be stolen from you.
She stole from you?
Yeah.
How'd I steal from you, Randy?
She overcharged him on beers.
I did not overcharge him.
I don't think Randy was wrong about the stealing. I sat there one Friday and watched her.
I have never stolen anything, Nadia.
We have an actual record of theft. Watch this.
This video came from my surveillance. So there's Kimmy. She's got the sweatshirt in her hands, puts the key back by the register, hasn't paid for it yet. Puts the sweatshirt on without putting any money in the register.
Do you deny that?
I always had the best of intentions of paying for them.
Now, Jeff, have you ever seen anything?
Yes.
So he knew it and let her come to work the next day. You're becoming an enabler.
Yes, I am.
You're enabling the drinking. You're enabling the theft. Come stand next to me. I want you to see what I see. Now, when you look at this, what is the worst offense in this entire group?
Stealing from me.
So what are you going to do?
I'm going to have to let you go, Kimmy.
Go get her out of here. Go do what you got to do. It's time to be a manager. Watch what she takes. Get her out of the building professionally. Let's end this correctly.
I can't even believe you just did this, Jeff.
I can't believe you're stealing from me.
No, I don't steal, Jeff. You know that. Have I ever taken a dollar from you? I don't steal, Jeff. You know that. You know I'm not a thief. I told Lexi or Missy to put them in there. I don't steal. I'm not stealing your clothes, Jeff. Come on.
What am I supposed to do?
I'm not denying that I took the clothes, Jeff, but it's not like I took them intentionally to steal them.
Look, I don't know what to do. I really don't.
Jeff, don't do this. You know I'm a good employee.
Hold on a second.
Hold on a second.
I'm getting nowhere with this. I need your backup.
She's fired. She leaves.
Instead of having the courage to fire Kimmy, he needs his girlfriend, Shelly, to do the dirty work for him.
I'm not a thief, Shelly. You know that.
Kimmy, I don't know that. I've seen you do it multiple times.
Sure, yes. It's more than that.
You let me down and you let Jeff down.
I'm not a thief, Shelly.
You took it, you wore it, you went home with it.
That doesn't mean I stole it, Shelly.
That's exactly what that is. What is your definition of stealing? If you take something that does not belong to you, it's stealing, Kimmy.
I've never stolen anything in my life. I'm not a thief. I've never stolen anything in my life, ever. I took a couple sweatshirts and a couple shirts out there with the perfect intentions of paying for them. I've worked for bars the last 15 years and nobody's ever called me a thief. Can you please come get me? I just got fired.
I want you to know, Sean, that Mike was ready to pull the plug a couple hours ago, correct?
Yes.
After training, you know that. You probably saw the look on his face. I sat down with him and said, listen, let's start stress test. Let's see what happens. Maybe Sean can change your mind. So if I accused you of things that are not true, tonight's your chance to prove me wrong. So it's up to you, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay.
What can we get you guys?
Now let the shrimp tacos.
Okay.
So we need three, 6, 7, 8, 9 shrimp tacos.
Kenny's obviously back there in the trenches making drinks with them. Sean is taking orders. He went from table to table, right? He should have brought that order in. Then he goes to the bar with 30 drinks at once and slams them. The problem with Sean is he's now taking orders from 4 tables in a row. He hasn't brought one of them to the bar. So as he's going to the second table, the third table, the fourth table, the first table still waiting for their drinks. Now he's going to go to the bar and slam them with 30 drinks at once.
There's one more ticket for you.
He hasn't touched a single ticket yet. Got to start making more than one drink at a time. Nobody's gonna get a drink if you're just making one at a time.
Oh, what the f*** is Sean? Tonight's pretty stressful. Sean told me I got your back. I'm gonna do everything I can to help you. But f***ing disappeared on me.
Yeah, two shrimp tacos.
And two shrimp tacos.
He's still taking orders. Has he put any of them in?
No. Nobody on that side got their first drinks, and that's been 30 minutes at least.
Sean!
One second.
Yes, sir.
How many drink orders did you just take?
I took, I've got 10 of them right now.
10 tables worth.
Now you're gonna hit the bar with 16 drinks all at once. You're not sequencing this. Now they're screwed, aren't they? So you're all screwed. Good job, Sean. Good job, buddy.
Prick. Asshole. He's putting them all into the POS system now.
Yeah.
They're all gonna print up at once, and they'll never be able to do this.
Absolutely not.
So this failure isn't because of the bartenders, strictly because of?
Poor management.
Oh, one second.
What are you making?
The Aloha Limes.
Okay. This is the drink you made today. How many are you making right now?
I'm making three of them.
So then you need three mixing glasses.
Yeah. Let me grab.
Tell her all of our mixing glasses. Right here.
Okay.
No, you start with the drink, you ice it afterwards.
What's the count on that?
Yeah. So a three-quarter lime?
Three-quarter lime.
This one?
Is that this one?
Yeah, so down the line.
Mr. Taffer, I've seen enough of it. He has no clue what he's doing. And I'm grateful that you came out here and brought all this to light for me.
So you're at that point?
I'm at that point.
Okay,
I got it. It needs to be done. Sean, we gotta talk.
Sean was just called out from behind the bar. Now he is gone. I'm not really sure what happened, but honestly, he wasn't helping anyway, so good riddance.
Oh, come on. Sean, as much as, man, I wanted this to work, Sean, you have no clue what you're doing here, man. It's obvious.
I'm not a bartender, no.
Sean, but you're not even a manager, man. It's
not true. That's absolutely.
Sean, over $100,000 this year in the hole. And I know that's not all on you, but you're the guy driving the ship. And, you know, it's I don't have confidence in you, man. I'm sorry, man, it's done. We're done. It's over.
This is bullshit.
Sean,
No, this is bullshit.
Just f*** me.
Bullshit, Mike.
Sean, I gave you every opportunity.
I was set up tonight to f***ing fail, and you know it. I was given the biggest f***ing section. I was given all those f***ing drinks.
It wasn't in my chair.
It absolutely was.
When we had three different bartenders make drinks, and they made three different f***ing drinks, who's responsible for that?
All of them, too.
You're not, Sean. You're the f***ing manager.
Kenny isn't responsible for it.
He is.
How come the
bartenders aren't responsible? But you're responsible for everybody.
Dude.
How much f***ing money are we losing on liquor? You're not even aware of it.
That was the first time I saw that today.
You have no clue. You sit your ass in the office every
that's
day.
Not true.
Bullshit.
That's
every
not
time
true.
I come here, I know exactly where to
that's
find you.
True.
Put your up in my shoes. What the would you do right now? What would you do? I'm not confident.
Bullshit.
I'm in the hole over $100,000.
You think you were managing? My goddamn fault.
What are you telling me?
You're the one that wouldn't let me run half the program.
How much money did you put
you
into?
You can't.
How
have
many checks did you write?
You can't.
How
have
many checks
money.
Did you write? This man wants to make a change.
I understand that, John.
Is that unreasonable?
That part of it is not unreasonable.
Okay, well then you had your chance.
The shit of me being set up specifically for failure tonight was unreasonable. The shit of me being
put, were fired before tonight, wasn't he?
Yes.
This has nothing to do with tonight.
So
you get
then
that?
That's the thing, John, is if I was fired before tonight, then what was the point?
Because I wanted you to prove yourself. I was wanting to give you one more chance.
You made up your mind.
Sean, you're full of shit.
You already even made up your mind.
Of course, because you're a shitty manager.
Well, thanks, John.
You're not a manager. It's time to go home.
I'm done arguing, man. It's over. I'm tired of excuses. It's obvious he has no clue what to do in a bar. And I'm mad at myself that I let it go this long.
This is bullshit.
Don't get turned,
your partner. I'm out of right now.
And this bar was bought by Frederica.
They might not just not be made up, but we should have some.
Her daughter, Amber, also works there. There's Amber.
I ain't got 10.
That's Tiana behind
it's
the bar.
What's she talking about?
You give me just a second, you can cash out, baby, okay?
You're losing money, about $6,000 a month or so.
Yikes.
You only have enough money to make it another 2 months. They're behind on your rent by 2 months. So, I mean, they're about to go down.
What is all that? Huh?
We have two cooks, and they're brothers. There's Derek, and there's Daryl. They both have two kids, and Frederica really loves them. Look at the side of the table. There's grease in every crevice
everywhere.
In this kitchen. Look at the flat top.
And it just builds up and gets worse and worse.
Chef, there's some danger in that kitchen there's for sure. Sitting down on his phone.
Clean something.
Okay, so that knife is now cooking a raw chicken breast. We don't know where that knife has been. Now the chicken's dripping on the other cutting board.
Wow.
Doesn't clean the cutting board.
My God. Raw chicken is like poison, and this guy is just spraying poison all over this kitchen.
I hope she put it in, because I'm hungry.
I ain't never really seen a couple of them before. I ain't seen a couple of them before. You seen them before? They like they're from the show.
I gotta tell you, we can't let this food go out, Jason. I say we go in. I'll go find Frederick. You go ahead in the kitchen right away.
Got it.
Let's call them out, inspect what's wrong, and remind these guys that they can get people sick with how they're cooking.
Hi, guys.
How you doing?
Hi. Hey, I'm John's expert. Dude, we were just watching. I've never in seen a kitchen this dirty in my entire life. Why are you guys smiling?
Why you not?
Look how dirty this is.
What's dirty?
What's dirty? Are you kidding me? What's dirty? You're sitting on your phone and you guys can't wipe something down?
Ain't that what you're here for?
Yeah, but you have to know better, man. This is not about being a chef. This is like common sense. Like, look at that. You think that's clean?
I didn't ever say it was.
So you guys are okay with how dirty this kitchen is? You're okay with a yellow cutting board?
First of all, don't come up in here trying to yell at me, disrespecting me on nothing,
bro. I'm not disrespecting you. This place is
disrespecting
dirty,
me, bro. Don't come up in here disrespecting me, bro. Bro, you could have came up here and said, hey, look at this, bro. Don't come up here disrespecting me, bro.
Let me rephrase it.
Rephrase it.
So why are you guys?
All right, that's all you had to say, bro.
What the hell happened last night?
Apparently, the way the guy came in, Derry had an issue with it. The way he was speaking to him and saying stuff to him.
So he had an issue. Gee, that's unfortunate, isn't it?
That's very unfortunate.
So the man is putting raw chicken on the same cutting board he's slicing a tomato on. He's not washing his hands. He's dredging chicken in flour that has raw chicken juice in it. God knows for how many days it's not refrigerated. Completely disrespectful to your future. But he was annoyed. How come you haven't been annoyed for the past month so far?
I've been very annoyed.
Were you his mom or his boss?
I'm his boss.
Doesn't seem that way, does it, Amber?
I'm his boss.
How much more time do you have before this place closes?
About 90 days, 60 to 90 days.
90 days. So if you don't change something, what's going to happen?
We're going to fail. We're going to end up closing the business.
Well, something has to change today. I'm going to lay it out there. You need to step up now and show me and show her that things are going to be different. And I'll give you some time to deal with this. I'll come in and let's have a whole team meeting and figure this out.
Okay,
go do what you got to do.
Derry.
Yeah, I knew this whole conversation was about me.
Yeah.
So listen, I need the business to grow. I really do. And you know I love you to death, but I have to let you go, okay? Thank you for everything.
Get me out of here.
Now.
So, are we one less of a cook, or?
We are.
Really?
Just me.
What's going on? What happened? What'd she say?
She said what she said.
How do you feel?
I'm good.
What's wrong with this place? Why are we losing money?
I don't know. Every time I feel like just, you know, cleaning and all that, but
me and my brother work so good together. Now he gone already. And he never act like that. And
don't leave, buddy. Don't leave, man. Do you want to go after him? He's a good guy. I don't want to see him walk out of here.
He's very emotional when it comes to his brother, so okay. He ain't leaving.
Well, go talk with him.
And that's my whole thing. Like, I feel like, so what? Like, I don't care that he was yelling. This man is coming into here to help all of us. A pro is coming in to help us. We really got to take some constructive criticism, because if something happens to this lady right now, she, God forbid, she dropped dead right now.
Come on. I know you're emotional. Come on, come on, come on, that's wild. Come on, come on. I know you're emotional. Calm down.
Man, what the f, man? I wouldn't even came on this. I knew this shit was going. Man, my brother never act like that. On one day, they gonna talk to me. Man.
Well, okay, come on, come on.
I'm trying to be respectful. I don't want to talk to him.
Daryl, I want you to have a conversation with him, okay? Yes. Can you do that for me? Daryl, listen to me. Just calm down.
Okay, where are they?
Derek is with him. They're in the corner posting
that. Are they walking away from me? If they want me to talk to them, I'll talk to them, but I'm not going to chase them. Are they coming back?
Daryl has unfolded his mic.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. So we have no kitchen staff.
150 people near my exact demographic, 21 to 29 year old. That's where the gold is.
Hi, how are y'all doing? What are you drinking?
A blue margarita.
I got a real-time online survey tonight. My customers are gonna tell me what they think of the food, the beverages, and how long it takes them to get served.
What do I drink?
Come on, guys, let's go. Gotta move. 12 medium wings.
Order in, my friend. I got a wing going 12 with medium, and I got a fairway burger going medium, wearing fries. Dude, what's going on with your grill, man? You're losing half your burger on your
grill. The grill was too high. You had it set on high, man.
I cook on high, dude. I make my grill work for me.
Yes.
This is unbelievable. We have 3 items on the menu. Kevin tells me that he's a culinary graduate, but you know what? I don't believe him. Stop flipping him. Let him cook!
Oh, that ain't gonna do it. I had to move it.
Don't tell me! Just stop doing it!
That's what I'm trying to do.
That's the type of stuff as an expediter and as an owner you gotta watch. And you gotta be able to communicate that. He's dude, get that burger off there. Throw it out. Every time you screw something up, dude, I'm gonna make you throw it out. You're not serving mediocre food while I'm here.
Work.
This is rookie mistakes, dude.
Every week I'm bitching, how can I eat all this food? And I didn't sell.
Most of it's getting thrown out. It's all us. I mean, it's gotta be. Either that or it's just waste.
You got anything about ready to come up?
Nothing.
That makes me nervous.
Nothing's come out of the kitchen yet.
Stop beating the shit out of your burgers.
There's no food out of the kitchen at all.
Nothing. We're at 18 minutes on our lead check.
Our first check, I can't get out of the damn kitchen.
Right here, it's a medium rare burger.
Move, Kevin! This is your ass! How can we run 18 minutes on a burger? What's the cook time on that burger, chef? 7-8 minutes?
It's a medium rare, 8 tops. We had to throw one away because we pressed it on the grill and the whole top of it stuck to the grill. So we had to start over with brand new burgers.
What the hell? Why the hell would you squeeze the juice out of a burger? Come on, guys, you got to catch up. Move, move!
Stop touching the burger! Let it cook!
That's exactly what I'm doing.
Oh, my. Can't get anything out of this place.
I can't get food anywhere, can't get drinks anywhere.
Do you understand how huge our problems are and how little time we have to fix them?
This is the oldest is the top one. My newest is the bottom one. I'm going to get this food out. Have a burger and some wings to stable.
Oh, Richard took the wrong food.
Oh. What's wrong with those wings?
These aren't theirs. Separate check.
Hey, guys, I need a margarita with no salt.
Okay.
For table 15. I don't know whose table that is, but I'm checking on their food right now. Guys, I'm running 40-minute ticket times. Let's get it together, please.
What the f*** happened?
I'm tired of talking. I need a leader out of somebody back here.
Table 15, it is an order of mild wings and an order of Cajun wings, and it's been a long time.
I'm not worried about it.
What do you think happened tonight? Do you think there was any success in this building at all?
I don't think we had any success at all.
How much food did we throw in the garbage tonight, Richard?
Hundreds of dollars.
Is there any chance that you're going to save your house with that food that came out tonight?
No.
You're losing $7,000 a month going to another job to support the bills in this business. Got a major problem, don't we?
We do.
James, how did it feel to cook in there tonight?
It was crazy.
No organization, no leadership,
no.
Right?
No.
What do you think, Duff?
I expect you to take over. I called the first order in, and then I stood back. And then I started to watch you cook. And I'll tell you what, I don't believe that you went to school. You cooked like a rookie.
I don't think that's accurate, man.
You don't even know how to cook a hamburger, man.
I can cook a hamburger.
You're squeezing it into the grill and squeezing all the juice out of it. Would you cook a hamburger that way?
No.
This is not about friendship. Your house is on the line. $100,000. Your reputation. This doesn't work. This place closes. You need some help running this place. You're an opportunity. You need to be an owner, and she needs to be a manager. Walking in and solving, saying, what can I do to help? Richard, what can I do to help? That's a manager. I want Michelle to be promoted. I want you to give her the authority. Do you believe in her?
I do.
Are you prepared to give her authority?
I'm gonna leave this house to you. You're not gonna be a full manager.
She can hire, she can fire. Now the next 2 days, I want you to prove what a great decision he just made. So what do you need to do to protect this business and your future?
I need to clean up the mess.
Where is that mess?
Next to me.
What are you gonna do?
This is an unnecessary mess. Kevin, you're fired.
You, dude.
Good night. Get out of here.
You don't know half the. You've been here for 2 days and in the back and all the other.
I had you pegged in 3 minutes. A fraud
you
is
had
easy
me pegged.
To see.
Yeah, smile on, piece of.
That guy hurt every one of you. Do you understand that?
Bitches threw me under the bus. Taffer's a idiot.
I have cooking awards. Michelle, she's worse than half the people there. And Richard's a piece of.
You made your future. He destroyed his.
Him.
So there's Nadia, bartender.
I guess we're the only bartenders that work in right now, since, you know, Nadia's not.
And there's Kimmy, our last bartender. We're walking into Drama City here, and there's one thing you and I know, drama does not work in a bar.
No.
Guys, been sitting over there without a beer.
I have no idea. I didn't do in a bar. I did not.
Don't
tell me.
You just told me you did.
Does this guy understand his staff is going to cause him to lose it all? Look at what they're doing.
This is ridiculous.
Oh! Whoa. I've never seen this type of employee interaction in front of customers before.
I mean, literally behind the bar.
It's a joke.
They're causing him to fail.
Mm-hmm.
We're here to stop him from failing, and it starts now. I watch your bartenders squirt each other with a soda gun.
Right.
Fight with each other. You're sinking, and they're causing it.
I know.
Here's the deal. Close the bar, get the staff together for a meeting.
Absolutely.
Your future starts now. Guys, we gotta fix this place. $1,100,000, can you imagine that? He's gonna lose everything. Guys, I want us to be one team. I've watched you spray her down with a soda gun.
I wanted her out from behind the bar. She was drunk. That's a liability.
But you don't do it in a way that all the customers see.
I feel like they don't respect me at all.
Respect is earned.
Every time that you drink, you're yelling demands that aren't even needed. I've got this.
Jeff, your lack of leadership is causing this. Do you understand that?
Yes, I do.
I gotta tough you up, buddy.
Absolutely. I'm in here somewhere, I think.
Right?
From this point on, I will not drink in this place ever again.
Do you believe her?
No.
I don't either. That's what worries me, Nadia.
I've got this. I can be what I need to be.
Kimmy! You need to get your attitude better, don't you? What are you gonna do to change that?
I'm gonna lose it.
Talk to me. What don't I know that's making you say that?
I shouldn't be stolen from.
She stole from you?
Yeah.
How'd I steal from you, Randy?
She overcharged him on beers.
I did not overcharge him.
I don't think Randy was wrong about the stealing. I sat there one Friday and watched her.
I have never stolen anything, Nadia.
I gotta show you this.
Okay.
Tim and his wife, Sarah, own the place.
Right.
Here's what's interesting. Tim was a marketing professional for a Fortune 500 company.
Right.
He posted this on his social media page. Sorry we had to close early. Was full.
If you were an owner of a bar and your manager did that, you'd fire him straight away.
I would not only fire him, I'd look him in the eyes and say, you're an idiot, and then I'd fire him.
Inside voices, please.
Look at this guy.
Chill out or get out. I don't go to your bar and act like a d-.
From what I can see, Tim is not a very nice guy. He insults customers who order premium drinks, and then he screams at customers for talking loud in his bar. Is this guy nuts?
There they go.
I'm not surprised. Why would you stay there?
Other than the three customers I sent in, those were the only four people in a whole bar, and he chased them away.
Where'd you go? Apparently I make drinks.
How is it?
It's like flat PBR.
That's horrible.
Yeah, even Sarah thinks the drinks suck.
Let me make you guys some drinks.
Actually, I want to try the French 75.
I'm gonna toss these. French 75 is great. Done.
Thank you.
Bing.
You know what, we got a superstar in her.
Yeah, I think so, John.
Did we make those right?
It's actually really good.
You know why? Because I didn't touch the bottle, probably.
Tim doesn't like the fact that his wife stepped in and is doing better than him. You should hope she does better than you if you want to make money.
I've seen enough.
Okay.
I just think Tim and Sarah just have a lot of problems with each other.
Ouch.
Do we have fights or issues here like that?
Yeah.
So are you uncomfortable when they fight?
We all are.
For employees to make money, they have to be comfortable in their environment. They have to be proud of it. When Tim and Sarah fight, all that pride disappears and the business loses money.
And it affects customers too. They don't want to hang out here. They want to go somewhere where they feel welcome.
Of course.
We had a big party, maybe 8 or 10 people. They spent probably $150, $175 in 20 minutes. Tim kicked them out.
They had to leave because they were.
What are you doing? You open the doors, you stand here and you pray every day that somebody walks through the door, and then you throw out half the people who come in. And here's the proof. You got an empty bar that nobody wants to come to and a bunch of people running around town saying you're a.
I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 drinks waiting here. He can't even make 3 properly.
It takes like 40 seconds.
Let's go, Tim, hurry up. John. Who's getting mules? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Mules. Holy.
You're falling behind, man.
Yeah.
I'm guessing this bar is the busiest it's ever been because they can't keep up. They're totally slammed. Tim is a disaster. This guy cannot tend bar.
Hey, can you not handle your well?
Obviously
if you
not.
Can't handle it, then I have to call in Tara and you're out of here.
I've got all these credit cards. I'm not fighting with you in front of customers.
They're all fighting too. It's really kind of intense back there.
I'm being polite and I'm smiling. Does everybody see me smiling? Is everybody having a good time?
Close out.
Long wait times and tension behind the bar drive patrons out the door.
It just made it kind of awkward to order a drink, you know?
It's not a good atmosphere to be around, for sure.
Hey, what's the deal? Can you not handle this?
I'm smiling.
If you can't handle it, you're out of here. Smiling doesn't make money. Drinks make money.
Stop talking to me.
Get out of the bar. You can't handle it.
Did everything turn out all right?
Honestly, these were really bad.
So we need to get you a new old-fashioned?
Yeah.
I need a replacement old-fashioned and a replacement martini because they didn't come out.
I need a replacement bartender if you don't pull your together.
Well, I've got a couple customers that weren't happy with their drinks. Said I'm going to buy them the next round. I know they didn't buy them for me, but I'm not here to talk. I'm here to get the job done.
You're sitting there yapping and we're doing work.
I know, and instead of saying, let's go ahead and fix that drink, you're yelling at me.
One thing I asked them not to do is no fighting behind the bar tonight.
Get out from the bar!
How's it going?
The two of them went at it again.
You know, it was like bashing heads, where I actually felt uncomfortable. So if I even feel uncomfortable, how
do all of them
feel?
Do. Yeah. Yeah.
Bye. Thank you guys for coming in.
Uncomfortable customers flocked to the doors after the busiest night in the Brixton's history.
All right, guys, huddle time.
You know, stress test wasn't very good, was it?
It was horrible. Tonight was a prime example of why people don't want to go back to the Brixton.
Fights behind the bar, the bartending falling apart, right? And rather than dealing with him as a bartender, you dealt with him as a husband back there.
You didn't yell at either of the girls when they weren't keeping up with you.
They saved your ass, dude. He tried, and I'll give him that, but when it came down to it, you know, he didn't pull through.
So Jack's Ale House is owned by three brothers. There's John, he's the oldest brother and also a retired firefighter. He owns another successful bar and he invested the profits from that bar into this one for 7% interest.
Hey Jimmy, there's no chicken wings in here, are you kidding me?
Yeah, there is.
There's Jimmy, he's the middle brother. He supposedly runs the day-to-day operations with his brother Brian, who's the youngest brother.
Oh, big guys.
Yeah, these guys are huge. All three of them are New York City firemen.
Jimmy, you ordered chicken wings, no chicken wings.
Blame it on me.
Do some work.
Okay, yes. You're being a
Don't order chicken wings, we have none. And whose fault is it? It's my brother Jimmy's fault.
Let's get it.
Yeah. You. Whatever.
Jim, easy.
Look at these guys screaming at each other. Bunch of hotheads.
Welcome, my name's Christine, by the way.
And there's Christine, she's Jimmy's wife. There's Catherine, she's a bartender, she's John's daughter. There's Kristen, she's a bartender, she's Brian's wife. The three brothers are in debt $400,000.
Yep.
They're losing about $10,000 a month. They're a couple months from closing, and the financial stress is destroying the family, not just the bar.
Wow.
Keep on doing what you're doing, Brian. About stacking beer and getting ice? That's what you're supposed to be doing. I get it done. Obviously, it's me, right?
You sit there like a little
Catherine, cut him off. Cut him off. He's been drinking since 10 o'clock this morning, man.
Do you understand you're being right now? 100%.
They're a bunch of fighting jerks. They're the customers you throw out of your bar, not owners.
Yeah, no kidding.
Why don't you commit arson on your body and burn yourself away? You're both annoying me right now.
It's embarrassing.
You.
Wow, people gotta be freaking out that these giants are going at it in the bar.
This business failed because
you! You're screaming with customers between them. These guys are ready to kill each other.
I think it's time to go in there, don't you?
Yeah, let's do it.
I wanna hire everybody
you
to
the f***ing bartender.
Wait in the f***ing bar. Making $20,000
a week. Who cares? The boss
move. What a freak show this is.
Oh, boy.
What are you doing, man?
You guys are screaming and yelling and getting ready to kill each other.
Between the two of you guys, I'm not sure who the biggest is.
He is.
And how much money do you have into this?
Too much.
Off. How much money do you have in, John?
$200,000.
Can you guys run this bar? Do you know how to do it?
We're too busy pointing the finger at each other that we don't see the whole picture.
I need it to Guinness.
I know. Everyone needs Guinness right now.
Back here is getting to be a cluster.
Christine, stop freaking serving them.
Jimmy and Christine are going at it with each other.
Wow, you're freaking annoying.
Stop it! You're stressing me out.
Am I the only one that's getting overloaded here?
You're slowing the whole thing down.
How many times has your husband said
a lot.
So that's the old Jimmy, still there, right? I made it clear to Jimmy this afternoon that he was to show discipline. Mr. Hero is no hero to me.
Listen to me. You say to either of these bartenders one more time, I will embarrass your ass. And I'll tell you one thing. You take one drink, I'll fire you in front of everyone. You hear me? You take another drink, I'll fire your ass in front of your brothers. That's the deal.
Who the are you talking to?
I'm talking to you.
Here's Chris. She's a bartender.
Well, because in the back fridge is the only place to keep them. There's like 12 bottles left.
There's Kristen. She's another bartender.
That is beautiful.
So she has created a promotion called Open Mic Night.
If any of you have a song or a poem or a story, perform. We want you. We want your passion. Yeah.
Hi.
Welcome.
Hi.
How you guys doing?
Good. How are you?
Good. Are you excited about Open Mic Night?
Do you guys have a beer list by chance?
We do not.
I'll take my pee.
Do you have any shouts?
One.
Thank you. This is not my mic.
I guess it's open mic night.
I guess.
Do you see any open mic stuff happening?
No.
This is the epitome of a bad bar promotion. You see, the worst thing you want to do is start something and then not get it going.
happened?
I don't know. I feel like it's
just. Do you not, like, release the pressure properly? Like, it's so basic. Like, how do you not know how to pull the nozzle properly?
It wasn't my fault. It just was, like, foamy.
That's why you need to pay attention, because if you would have done that properly, you would have sprayed everywhere and it wouldn't be an issue. You wouldn't be covered in beer. They wouldn't be covered in beer.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, my God.
If they could quit bickering, they would be much better off. Chris is just completely unapproachable. She walks around with a scowl on her face. You know, these two are polar opposites.
The bartender's gone. Okay, she's singing. So that's good.
Woo-hoo! How are you guys doing tonight? All right, Star, welcome to Open Mic Night. This is my vision, but without you guys making this happen, it would definitely not happen. Chris is going to be performing one of my favorite songs that he does. It's called Turn It Up. Because the night is turning down, let's turn it up.
Okay, so this is starting to make sense now. So Kristen is the only one performing on Open Mic Night. So why do you think Open Mic Night exists?
Because Kristen needs a platform to showcase her talent.
The only thing I'm thinking of is you. Please and
woo! Come on, girl, I'm getting frisky. Can't take the whiskey.
I'd kill the mic if it was me.
Oh. Night is turning down, turn it up.
They're not even singing the same notes.
Turn it down. Woo. Yeah.
Wow. So, let me tell you about your promotion last night. The production sucked. The song sucked. You guys are singing that song in two different keys. That was not rehearsed.
One thing that makes Open Mic Night great, though, is that people come in here and it just flows on its own without having too much structure.
That's wonderful. Peace, love, flowers. But the fact of the matter is, I'm here to monetize a business. And none of that, what you just described, is creating sales. Now, if somebody stands up there and does it and everybody applauds, but the cash register doesn't ring, what's the point?
Exactly. We're definitely not meeting those standards at all.
Chris is never really here on Open Mic Night, so she wouldn't know.
Whatever, you just don't want to hear it. Kristen is in her own reality. And that different reality that she's in, it does not translate to business.
I do my best. That's all I can say about that. I don't.
You tell everybody about Open Mic Night and it's a show. It sucks.
That's a little harsh.
It's not.
Because this is what you do, is that you take something and you make it bigger than it really is, and it's a huge issue. And
if it's not something you want to hear, you just don't hear it.
There's Dahlia, she's our owner.
Okay.
My tits are not sweaty, look.
Oh, please, please.
They're not sweaty. All I have to say is real women have curves.
Chill out, relax.
I don't care what people think.
There's Crystal. Crystal is Dahlia's daughter and a bartender.
Do you have a card or can I start your time?
There's Melissa, she's a bartender.
Everybody's just standing around and I'm just doing everything like always because I'm the badass.
Not exactly the sweetest girl I've ever seen.
What are you doing, Ed?
Ed is a bar back.
I set up the bar a certain way. That's why I want how I want it.
There's Kara. She's a bartender.
Who's got the balls to flip me for the house around? I buy or you buy? I say tails never fails, and you're buying the house around.
There you go.
Ready? That's a
Why would she do that when people are already drinking?
I will honor this. I will buy the house around, but it's my choice. You don't pick, mother washing the tables around the room.
They're already drinking.
Mm-hmm.
If you ran a promotion, people might come for it, but if they're already there, you're just costing yourself money.
Exactly.
Cheers to the shot that Dahlia bought for the house for no reason. You better give me half of that. You hear me? You better give me half of that. Hey, where are you going, Melissa?
Take a break.
What do you mean, take a break?
It's her turn. I'm gonna take a break, is what I mean.
I've been in there for 2 hours. I can take a break.
Breaks are every 4 hours, not every 2 hours.
Mm-hmm. I don't have to go in there and serve drinks.
Okay, so we have an attitude issue here, Mia.
100%.
They're not without me.
I guess Melissa's still on our break. Shall I go get her or are you gonna go get her? Never mind, you just sit there like you always do.
I'm f***ed up. I'm so f***ed up.
So she's drunk?
Yes.
And it is about 9:30. So she's got 4 hours to go. So what are they gonna do, carry her home?
What the f-? Are you done with your break? Are you done with your hour break?
Oh, wait, hold on, I'm about to smoke another cigarette.
Like, are you serious right now?
No, I'm about to literally smoke another cigarette.
You can't be taking an hour break.
Work seems like an inconvenience to her.
Yes, that's a very appropriate way of putting that.
No.
What are you doing right now?
Having a great time.
Maybe you shouldn't do that anymore. I have no interest in your freak show.
Really?
And you're the worst of all. How many times did you say behind that bar tonight? Did you say it?
A few.
A few. So she chased out a few. You chased out a few. Who's left? Your business is like your boobs. It's sagging.
I don't have fleas in the restroom.
We have what?
Fleas in the restroom.
Fleas? Are you kidding me?
No,
there's Megan, her daughter.
She has flip-flops on in the kitchen.
First of all, that's illegal. Not to speak of how dangerous it
is. Yes, you have oil and you have these fryers and grills and, I mean, carrying the food and...
Oh, that's disgusting.
There's Cheyenne, she's a bartender.
Okay.
Boy, not a lot of smiles there, huh?
Not what I would call approachable.
Move, bitch, get out the way.
There's Lisa, and there's Susan.
Mucho fudo!
No, I'm just kidding.
Please, let me make them.
No, she asked me specifically.
Yeah, but she likes mine better.
No, she's not. Dude, Cheyenne, on the cool, like, this is nothing to do.
How many?
Can you move out of my way, dude? Like, this is what I was told.
But I'm on the clock now.
I don't care. Like, they asked me. Dude, I'm not going to take the bottle.
But they asked you because you were sitting at the table.
No, they asked me because she
will. No,
I'm not going to argue with you. On the cool. Like, I'm doing what I was told to do.
No, I'm going
to
make them. What do they want?
Okay, then I'm going home.
Bye.
Bye, Mom. I'm leaving.
I'm mad, Mommy.
She's acting like a six-year-old
girl.
Wow. She didn't know back there.
Yeah, she did.
Mom,
she
just
did.
Shut up.
The
just
crap.
Stop.
You don't even know.
Just stop.
This would be outrageous if it was in their living room. Look at the customers looking right at her.
She didn't know back there.
Yeah. It's like dinner and a show.
You don't even know.
You're so
when you in, then you can say something to me.
Oh, my gosh.
So she was never taught respect. So she doesn't respect her father's money, her mother, the business, the customers. She respects none of it.
Usually you see patrons fighting with each other, but not the bar.
Yeah, not the actual staff.
Bar.
Hey, I'm out of here. I'm done with
really,
this.
Really, Megan?
I'm done.
She walked out on her mother, on her family business. She just walked out.
Man, she's lucky I didn't knock the out of her. I don't know who the she thinks she is. If she knew how to do something, then I wouldn't have to do it.
Guys, look up for just a second. Who still doesn't have a drink? Look around. Who doesn't have a drink still? Put up your hands so they can see. Okay, Dante, come on, guys. Let's catch up.
Order up.
So what happens? You guys send it up as it comes up, or you send it together?
Oh, we got it. Two things.
Yeah, you send it together, right?
Hold on.
No,
not yet. We got the hush puppies.
So what's the system here? Is it as the food is ready, you send it, or do you wait to do whole tables?
We actually send it when it's up, but then everything's not ready at one time.
Yeah, so but I mean, you have to time it. That's where it comes in. Otherwise, we're just slamming food. What good is that? All right, we're starting to get hit a little bit. Starting to come in, tickets are coming in, but it's like lack of systems. They're not sure when to send one dish or cook the other dish. It's just, it's
are there table numbers on the tickets? Guys, do we know where every order's going?
Just as I suspected, there's no systems in place. They don't have any steps in place. There's no process in place. So just a free for all.
Well, let's see what happens. Let's see if the right food gets to the right table.
I'm sorry, darling. I wasn't ignoring you. Are you waiting on your drinks?
We got to get these tables done.
You got it.
Oh, you switched tables on me.
No, what table number?
This is supposed to be table 5.
Okay, gotcha.
But they switched tables.
Okay.
We were doing so well, and now the kitchen crashed completely. Food isn't going out. We're running about 25 minutes behind. Surprisingly, the bar's catching up, but the kitchen isn't.
Don't get ahead of yourself. You're cooking too much too fast. We're waiting on this, right? So give me this, then go to the next ticket. So do a ticket by ticket, you know? quality control. That's what we're looking for. If you try to do too much, the quality starts to lack. We're doing super easy food. We just got to get that rhythm. You guys are slamming food like nobody gives a f-. We give a f- now, you know? Why do this four times? Here, come on. You have a pot. Look, you have a pot right here, you know? So bring the pot to you. One, two.
We got to get the systems in here, guys.
Now bring the shrimp to you. Don't do one at a time. It's crazy.
Get them out as quick as you can.
Look, look. I don't want to serve shit like that. Just one, two, three, four, and a garnish. Okay, I don't want to show you again. I just want you to get it right. Don't be sorry. Just do it right.
No, I'm...
Guys.
All right, Charlie, can you check on food? They got to try to speed up back there if we can.
Okay. Chef, what's going on with the plate and the food is coming out kind of slow.
Yeah, there needs to be some help expediting this.
Okay, Rob, we need more help expediting food to the tables.
All right,
okay, so is this the double order that happened? They switched tables, that's why this was double.
Okay, I'm just serving what I see.
No, sweetie, I'm just letting you know.
All right.
What happened was my customers moved. When I moved their ticket over, I changed the table, and I guess it messed the kitchen up, but it's just sometimes, you know, it gets a little bit frustrating. It's okay. So we don't need this.
You need it now.
Hey, man bun.
Man bun, okay.
Man bun. He want a sidecar without the bullshit.
I heard. It's like, you taste this? Did you use this?
Yep.
It tastes so much better.
It give it that orange taste to make it pop more.
Now you're mixing this up. You're doing some of the service tickets too, right?
Yeah, I'm doing a little bit of everything.
Try to mix it up.
I'm about to do everything. I'm trying to get everybody.
Okay.
It's like a normal thing. Normally I'm back there by myself anyway, so it's always stress for me. So I'm a real worker, man. I really try and bust it out and get people, make people happy. So it's just the way I am.
These guys, you got some good guys in the kitchen. Real good guys.
So what's the cost of this, Chef?
Maybe 75 cents tops.
So we're making money on everything now, right?
That's it. And it's just the hush puppy. It's just fried flour. But we elevate it in a way that just perceived value, you know?
The flavor.
Here I go.
Dante, did you get those tickets out that we gave you? If you can, make two at a time, three at a time, okay? Dig us out.
I've become a pretty big fan of Dante and David. Their attitude is great. They're really trying. And with more training, I believe they'll get there.
Dante.
What do you think? You look good? You see him in that?
He's done. He's done.
Okay, okay.
Here, son.
Here you go.
Here, son.
There you go. There you
go. I got you.
Man, guys, Dante, come on over a sec. One sec.
I just want to tell you, I'm proud of you guys. I'm proud of everything that we did tonight. This was badass.
I mean, you know, after the little meeting we had earlier, when you start running numbers, it started clicking in my head, we got to get this shit together.
We do, and you freaking did, man. Stepping up is the best thing that we can ever do as men. To step up in those moments, and you guys freaking did, man. You guys did. So let's shut this down. Let's tell everybody good night. I got to start remodeling this place. I want to go to work.
You still want me to make these two, right?
Yeah, make those two. Give a last call, and let's move on, okay, guys?
Attention, please. Hear ye, hear ye. Last call for alcohol. Stress test, it was kind of, it was rocky, but you know, once we readjust and got a hang of it, it was cool. I liked it, it was a good experience. It's real serious. Oh, hey.
This is amazing.
What do you guys think?
Love it.
I love the neighborhood soul.
Thank you, John.
Yeah.
Appreciate you, man.
Neighborhood soul, because that's exactly what we is, the neighborhood soul.
Exactly.
Marshawn, what do you think?
I'm feeling it.
You're feeling it. You all have gained my respect this week. That neighborhood soul was about your soul, not about a building, not about food.
You did it. You did that.
You gotta see the inside.
Look what the big homie did. Big homie Taffer. Look at the big homie. Nah, you the big homie now.
Okay, so there's only one thing left. You guys ready to go see it?
Yes.
All right, go ahead.
Let's do it.
Oh, shit. Wow. Oh, my God.
This is so nice.
What the f***? Look at that.
Nah, we gotta go over there, look. No, y'all didn't see the mural over there, look, look.
Oh, I love it.
This is big. That's hella
dope. That's dope.
I got emotional when I saw the years of Marshawn in the picture. He's such a great person.
Look at our commercial.
It's mad. That looks like Ray Ray's Boom Boom Room.
What do you think? I got a smile?
Hell yeah. Look, he already at it.
Whose back is that in that mural? I just
said that. That's you.
No, that's Rob Ben, watching you become a hero.
Rob is most definitely is in the house, man.
It is an amazing day here at Das Brewhaus and Cafe. So come on in, bring your smiles, because we brought ours. Hey, what's going on? Nice to see you.
Hey, how are you?
How y'all doing?
Really love this strawberry sage smash. It's a whiskey drink, but it's phenomenal.
I'm loving the new drink menu. They're nice, refreshing, and people are starting to love it. I've never seen this many smiles behind the bar or in front of the bar ever in this restaurant, and it's great. This bar finally has good vibes again, and I'm glad. I'm very happy about it.
Ladies, you got this. We're doing good.
I got a new chef coat tonight from John, which was amazing. I'll wear that jacket very proudly, and I will do my best to make Doug and Tara proud of me.
You got a lot of stuff?
Yeah.
Cool. Well, welcome back.
How are we doing?
Once he's finally taken a breath and thought about his recipes and his pour counts, he's actually digging himself out from service well.
Yeah, he's a good guy. If he stays organized, he can do this.
He can, yeah.
I think we're in the clear. The crowd is so happy. They're raving over the drinks. The food is consistent. I think everyone's going to come back. This is a sign of a very successful relaunch.
A little different than the other night?
Most of it different.
How long did it take you to get your food?
5 minutes.
Good?
Yeah, delicious.
Excellent. This is a great lady with two young kids. She's $1 million in debt. Spreading the word from you guys can make a big difference.
Sure.
Thanks, guys. Enjoy your summer.
Yeah.
And we'll see you guys on the field.
Yeah. All right, sunshine, double time that I brought. That sells me, baby. I got it.
Doug, the whole room is almost served. You freaking did it. We did it. Guys, we did it. We pulled this off.
Schnitzel.
Did it. Well done. Yeah. So what does everybody think of the bar? You like it? Woo! So, who's coming back?
Yeah!
Yeah!
Here's Dave, back behind the bar.
Go do something.
I'm trying to. I'll be over here.
It'd be nice if he'd help out his bartenders. Wash some glassware, making sure everybody's okay. He's just kind of standing there doing nothing.
Little rat face, man. Now buy him a set of teeth.
This guy's a dick.
Yes.
Val, she's our favorite lesbian, though. Keep the faith, Val.
For recon tonight, I have Joe Escalante. Joe is the bassist from the legendary punk rock band, The Vandals. He's been active in the punk rock scene for 35 years.
I've played at places like CBGB's, The Whiskey, and the Roxy. You got to stay current on music trends, because if it's the best bands playing the best songs, people will come back.
I got Jennifer Allen, who's a good friend of mine and is a local, knows Long Beach really well. Then I got Sarah Colonna. Sarah's an entertainer and comedian. And then with her is John Ryan, who's Sarah's fiance and happens to be the punter for the Seattle Seahawks.
How are these kooks, dude?
Hi there.
Hi, how are you?
Good. What can I get you guys?
Cape Cod.
Okay.
Look at the crazy variety of pour spouts they have here. And some of the bottles don't even have any pour spouts at all, which makes it much easier to overpour.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sorry, sure.
It's just so strong.
How do you screw up a vodka and cranberry juice?
It doesn't smell great here.
No. I feel like
a
band.
I live in a football locker room, and I still don't think it's fun. You can't get much more than that. But...
it's definitely dirty behind the bar. Actually, that light socket looks like it could kill somebody at any moment.
You should have worn a condom into the bar.
Do you guys serve food?
We're working on trying to get a kitchen in here, but for now, we don't have one.
No, it's fine.
From what I understand, Dave wants to add a kitchen to his bar. But if he can't get anything right, what makes him think he can run a successful kitchen?
Exactly.
Oh, good. The band's arriving.
What's up, Black Light District? How are you doing tonight? Wow!
Oh, man. Okay, Jen's covered in here. Punk rock should be loud. but it can't be piercing. So when you're bringing the volume up, because the system stinks, it becomes intolerable for you. It creates an unsafe environment for the customers and staff and could lead to irreversible ear damage. I mean, it's unprofessional.
Right.
It's gonna be like this every night. I'm not gonna come back. As a musician, I would not wanna play here because the bar is not designed to have live music. It is amplified like that. And it just doesn't look like anyone's gonna survive this way because in a punk rock world, the scene here is too limited to be successful.
Look at that. There are only three customers that are actually tolerating this noise. I can't subject my spies to this headache of a bar anymore. I say we go in together. Mm-hmm. You hit the bar. Let's see what we got.
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah! Phil, you want to look at the bar for a minute?
Yeah.
Yeah. The end of the day.
Oh, hey, he's here. Hey, Gabe's here. What do you think, Joe?
It's a tough room. And if you get booked in this place once, you will tell your agent next time, let's not go back there.
I'm Phil.
April.
April, pleasure. Mind if I walk you and take a look at the bar?
Okay.
Dave. Come on over.
Jon Taffer.
David.
How's it doing? I'd like to meet some friends of mine. Jon is the punter for the Seattle Seahawks.
David.
Hi, Sarah.
Sarah Colon is a dear friend of mine. Sarah is a comedian.
Hi.
Jennifer Allen is local. And Joe Escalante David. Is the bassist for the
nice
Vandals.
Oh, really? Wow.
Did this bar work for you?
It didn't smell great, and the drinks were very strong.
Did it work for you?
No, it doesn't work. It needs help.
I'm told you're about $160,000 in debt.
Yeah, this is why we kind of challenged you. We didn't think you were able to meet the challenge of a punk rock scene.
Oh, really, Joe? Is there any punk bar that can fill up 365 days a year?
Not playing punk rock. No, it's just not a business. And I've been in the punk rock business most of my life.
You can't flounder in here in a sweater and just say I'm punk rock. It doesn't work like that.
David, listen, respect somebody who's legendary in the punk rock space who grew up playing in venues like this.
You guys flew in on the wrong plane. We don't want you here anyways. This is not an emo bar or a house music bar.
If you think you can run a punk bar and make money 350 days a year, I suggest that you don't know punk music at all.
I think it's a crock.
Well, you guys don't need to hear me argue with an idiot, so I'll let you go, Joe.
Thank you.
Would you rather be in the punk business or make money?
Honestly, I'll shut it down knowing that we did the punk rock thing other than selling out the punk rock scene.
You want to not be a sellout? Don't be a sellout then!
I'm going to keep it punk rock, dude. And if it's not punk rock, then fly home, dude.
So, for recon tonight, I got two friends of mine. This is Dan from Barstool Sports, which is one of the most popular sports websites in America. I've had Dan do recon for me before.
I like that.
I mean, I've never had lighter fluid, but like, it's a hot drink.
If Dan likes a bar, he can make it successful. If he doesn't, he can make it fail with the push of a button. Next to him is Chris Long, who's a current player with the Rams. As a Ram, Chris Long knows this town. He knows the sports market. And I've asked the two of them to come into your bar and give me feedback.
Hi, guys.
What's up, man?
What's going on?
How are you?
Yeah, can I get a Bud?
And how about you, hon?
I have a Bud Light.
Whoa! What kind of pouring is he doing?
Cheese for what? Thanks a lot, man. Appreciate it. Yeah, what do you think?
Here's a little, flat, maybe? How can you succeed pouring a bad beer in St. Louis? This is the home of Budweiser.
That's an embarrassment.
Cheese,
Mimo,
fries.
Absolutely, thank you.
I'll do Reuben nachos. And that's our cook, Anthony.
Freeze and burn, freeze and burn.
Now he's microwaving the burger meat to thaw it out. He should already have the meat prepped and thawed before service begins. This is just lazy cooking.
Whoever wants to put these goggles on can have a shot for free.
Cameron, no, come on.
Kim tries, but she doesn't have a clue. He does not behave like this when I'm there.
But this is the real him.
Is our food coming?
Is that burger done yet?
So they don't have their food yet.
Oh,
which
no.
Has been, what, a good 15 minutes or so?
Yes.
That's totally wrong. Yeah. The cheese is wrong. You know what? F*** it. Just put the french fries. I'm done.
What is that?
That's the Reuben nachos.
Oh, no. You're a restaurant person. You know how important food quality and consistency is.
That is a huge issue with me.
It's a nacho.
I'm the nachos.
Please speak up.
These chips are awful. There's so much sauerkraut and Thousand Island, and none of the cheese is cooked.
How's the burger?
I'm not a stickler about hamburgers, but for us, it was disappointing because they were the basics. You know, how do you mess nachos up? How do you mess a burger up? It wasn't good.
For recon, I got two Kansas City Chiefs offensive linemen, Mitch and Andrew. They know bars, they know this town. I thought they'd be perfect to give us a scoop on recon. So this is a big moment for Billy and his staff. Let's see if they deliver.
What are we having tonight?
I'd usually do something like mixed, maybe a little sweet or fruity.
You can do like a Long Beach, which is basically a Long Island, but with cranberry juice.
I'll give that a shot.
Did you give them a menu?
I don't know what to order. I need to look at their menu.
So she's made no effort to sell them anything.
Ooh, we're getting live over there.
So the shot comes first. Let's see, now she's gonna clean up the shots.
That was a
She now has everybody's saliva on her hands, right, from touching the rim of all those glasses. Wipes her mouth with her hands, puts her hands through her hair. She's doing it all wrong. She hasn't done one thing right.
Long Beach.
Oh, look at the color of that.
I'm actually confused at what she just put in there. Even if it's sweet and sour and cranberry, that color is not normal.
That's good. It's not doing much. It's just like kind of watered down.
Oh, man.
So what's the deal with ordering this food again?
OK, so you're going to go to the food window? You're going to order from the food window?
Now, the fact that she couldn't write it down and bring it over there with the 9 customers they have in a room is absurd.
So I don't get why you can't just like order there, but whatever.
You guys got any question about the menu?
Now, would you ever order food from a guy with that towel on his shoulder like that?
Not at all. I would ask him, did you clean your neck with that towel? I just want to know.
Here, I get food. I'm going to order just the big burger.
Can I just get a grilled chicken?
And that's going to be at least a 30-minute wait. You guys okay with that?
30-minute wait, at least.
Razzo's supposed to have a shot with the girls over there.
I know.
I wonder how many shots she's had tonight.
What kind of owner would just say whatever?
Shrug it off.
She can get drunk, steal money, fall. You know what I'm saying? I don't understand it.
And whose booze is she drinking? Billy's.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Here we go. So he's thrown raw chicken on the grill, Kev. Has he washed his hands?
Not at all. Look at one in a bag.
Yeah. Now he's going in a bag for?
Not
oh,
for chips. So that whole bag would have to be thrown away. Look at that.
So those aren't nachos. Those are more like deathos.
Yeah.
Right? You can eat some raw chicken on your nacho chips. Can you imagine?
No, I don't want to.
Look at that grill. Now, I thought that was a charbroiler. It's so black. That's a flat top.
That thing ain't been cleaned since the early 70s.
Now, whatever he's cooking has got to come out with some black on it, doesn't
it? Yeah, no doubt.
Wipes that rag again, touches it all with his bare hands. Oh, man. And now with his spatula, he goes to scoop up that chicken. And what goes with the chicken on the bun? Some of that disgusting grill.
Her eyes are definitely glazed over.
John is heading to Oakland, California for a very special bar rescue to help football legend and hometown hero, Marshawn Lynch. In 2018, Marshawn Lynch opened the doors to Rob Ben's, a local restaurant and bar in the heart of Oakland.
I think every time I've been in this restaurant since it's opened, there's somebody from the community that I actually know. And for them to tell me, like, you know, I'm proud of you and, you know, what you're doing.
It's an honor to meet you. I'm a big fan, boy.
Man, you don't know the half, big dog.
So your career, everything started right here.
Yeah.
So how far was it from here where you grew up?
Around the corner. But my first game was 2 or 3 blocks away from here.
So this is your home. Your career started here.
Right. It started and ended here.
How perfect, huh?
Yeah, I think they call that, what's that, Cinderella store?
Yeah, it is a Cinderella store. You had one hell of a career, buddy.
Man, it was all right.
It's all right.
Yeah.
My respect for you is immense.
Clack, clack. Thank you. Appreciate it, big dog.
Hey, Ray.
I got one Skittles.
Yeah.
And and she'll have the side part.
Well, I gotta tell you, it's a nice looking bar. I like the colors, you know, I think the black and red is pretty cool.
It's black and burgundy. But I opened Saints. One of the first time Rob came to see me play, I was playing for Saints. So that was where the color scheme had came from.
So connected back to Rob.
Yeah.
Wow. So I want to hear about Rob.
Yeah. I ain't gonna lie to you. It's more of a touchy subject with that. I mean, you know, it's just my brother. Just from shit as early as I could remember opening my eyes, he'd been in my life. And, you know, it was taken away from me. Just the impact that he left on my life. The name of the restaurant is just in honor of him.
So he's been a large inspiration in your life?
Facts. We've got his older brother that's working in there, too.
Wow.
Yeah.
So his family is in there with your family?
Oh, most definitely.
As it should be.
Yeah.
Hey, can I order something? Try and catch him when he's not busy.
Yeah. Dude, he's drinking behind the bar. Is that cool? Who this guy?
Somebody back there don't give a.
Can I get a drink? Can I go into your cellars? Can I get a cellar too?
What can I get you?
Do you have a salad with grilled chicken?
Let me check. I got you. Let me check. I got you. Hold on.
You think you would know that?
Got a chicken salad.
Okay.
I can tell him grill it.
Now, can you do grilled chicken on the salad? Okay.
You got a chicken salad?
Where do you see a chicken salad?
Now, do they have a chicken breast in there?
We don't have a chicken salad.
From what I just heard, we don't.
We don't have a chicken salad.
I wonder if that was echoed back to her.
Let's see what happens.
Do you mind checking on our food for us?
You should be coming up next.
Unfortunately, they don't have any more salad.
No salad.
No salad at all.
My mom ordered the fish, but I was thinking chicken.
This is pretty simple. So they couldn't pull off a salad with chicken.
Right.
And they're still dealing with this. Meanwhile, this person ordered this like 10 minutes ago.
Right.
And they still haven't solved it.
Mm-hmm.
So now they're just
putting in order. That was 10 minutes ago when they knew that they didn't have the grilled chicken.
So they're reacting too late.
Right.
And nobody's communicating with each other.
Mm-hmm.
We got to run this more like a team, less like a family. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Everybody's got to hold up their own. Everybody's got to freaking deliver. As a team, we lose. You give them the opportunity. Now they got to freaking seize it.
That's what time it is.
That's what time it is. It's time to seize it.
Hey, you might have been all right coaching the league. You got me ready to go and bust some motherfucking heads right now.
I want to go. Let's go in and talk to them.
How long does it take to pick this up? This has been sitting here for a half hour. How long does it take to pick those up? Hold on, I'm not done.
I'm just saying it.
How about picking this up, for Christ's sakes? So how many times do you walk by this and not pick up anything?
You wait till they finish.
I don't understand it. What do you do here?
So I'm the only person in here.
You walked by it 10 times.
No.
This has been here long before I even got in a room.
So before I even came back here,
I was sitting back here, bro.
And I didn't even walk back here, bro. I'm not a server. I'm a bartender.
You know, the more you talk, the more of an idiot you sound like. You walked by it and didn't do it.
You walked by it.
End of story.
I don't hear it.
How many times do I walk by this? How many times do I walk by this? How many times do I walk by that and expect you to keep writing checks?
Now look, I got the glasses. What are you doing?
I had to tell you to.
You had to tell me things.
You had me in a bed
talking to me. What the f*** you talking about?
Because you f***ed up. You f***ed up and he writes the check. Is that fair?
Why don't you do something?
I am doing something. Calling you out.
Me.
That's what I'm doing.
Am I the only motherfucker in here? I'm motherfucker
down. Do better.
Here, you want to ride me?
You
sir? Here. Hold on.
Do better.
I'm from the school streets.
Calling you out.
F***ing me. You put this motherfucker down here.
I'll show you something. Somebody can actually work in this shirt, even though you didn't.
F***ing me.
Is this reasonable?
At the end of the day, bro, I ain't gonna lie to you, though. Check me out, though, cuz. Check me out, though, cuz.
It's the biggest screw up here, that's all.
Check me out, though, cuz. The whole point of all the shit, why he telling you what he telling you is, that's coming out of my pocket.
Let's go back to the kitchen for a second.
No, you did. I just watched you and her.
Well, here I am for my 200th
bar rescue episode. So tonight, to help me with this rescue, I have two of the Las Vegas Raiders with me to help me do recon. I'm gonna do 200 right.
There they are.
What's up, big man?
How are you guys, man?
Doing good, doing good.
Thanks for coming.
Thank you for having us.
So this was a big one for me, guys. This is my 200th bar rescue.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So I'm thrilled to have you guys.
Excited for you. Thank you.
So this bar is owned by a family.
Right.
So I was hoping you guys could go in, have some food.
Yeah.
Which you haven't had in a while.
Yeah.
Have a drink or two. You know, and just let me know what you think.
Okay.
Sorry. Right. Cool, guys. I'll see you inside.
Okay. Hey, guys. How are you doing today?
How you doing?
How's your night going?
Good.
So think about this. During the pandemic, how would you feel about being handed a menu that was obviously used before?
Terrible. I wouldn't touch it.
You wouldn't touch it with
no.
your hand? But that menu's all folded up. Obviously, that's been used before, right?
Uh-huh.
I think I'll do the mezcal margarita.
Okay. The paloma? Yeah. Tequila with lime juice and triple sec.
No! There is no triple sec in a paloma! Okay, that is not real lime juice. The only thing authentic about that is the lime wheel. There was no fresh ingredients whatsoever.
Here you go, guys.
Thank you.
Mezcal margarita and paloma for you.
Thank you.
Excuse me, you want me to leave a one menu on it?
How's that drink?
I should have told him to make it a double. Barely. I mean, if I was, you know how when you're a young kid and your dad let you sip a taste of beer, it tastes like that, like they put a drop of tequila in there.
So it's not right then?
No, it's not strong enough. Unless the tequila just got a whole bunch of sugar in it.
Oh, he doesn't like that at all. He's puckering up from that.
Is this supposed to have like grapefruit?
No grapefruit.
It's like kind of too strong.
If you don't like it, I can change it for you, sir.
Yeah, can you make it a little bit
less alcohol for you?
Yes,
sure, you got it.
Thank you.
May I have another margarita?
Sure, you want the same, the mezcal one?
No, that one didn't have enough alcohol in it. I don't know what's good. I want to taste the good stuff.
Okay.
Yeah.
I just feel like I want to run and try. It's just, it's overwhelming.
Carne asada, cuatro camarones, four shrimps.
30 minutes and nothing has come out just yet. Nothing.
Go.
No.
She looks a little stressed, doesn't she?
It's not even stressed.
Holy shit.
Dress it up. Dress it up, yo le pongo todo.
Now, this cook doesn't know what he's doing, so I'm curious to see how this goes. If there's one thing that freaks me out, it's what?
Cleanliness.
Raw chicken.
Oh, jeez.
Look at this. Look at the cross-contamination.
Same glove.
How do you like the chicken?
Look at him touching protein with his hands.
This is terrifying.
Oh. This is completely cross-contaminated. I have to go in this kitchen. You know who I am?
Yes, sir.
Do you want me to help you?
Yes.
Come with me. This man is gonna kill somebody.
Okay.
There's raw chicken on here, right? Now he has salad on it.
Okay.
He takes raw chicken, goes in the refrigerator, grabs all the food. All of this food is covered in raw chicken. None of this can be served. You think it's funny? Do you know that he's touching raw chicken with his hands and then grabbing salad and then touching meats with his hands?
Oh my God.
What happens, Claudia? No.
Cross-contamination.
You can kill someone. Shut all this equipment off. I want to see you guys out front.
I'm super overwhelmed. Overwhelm is not even a word right now. I don't know what to do. I don't know what's next.
Here's what I did. I brought three NFL players into your bar. Three Tampa Bay Buccaneers, Bo, Cam, and Allie. Three NFL players are just sitting in there right now.
Dude, you have no idea how much food we're gonna order.
Yeah, we're gonna get a bunch of food.
All right, that's cool with me.
Caesar wrap, please.
Can I get two fish and chips and the salmon?
Can I get the bacon?
Three guys, one order.
Perfect, thank you.
Thanks.
I wanna watch the kitchen with you make this food. Okay, let's go in your bar.
Yeah. I'm hungry, dude.
As soon as I see John, I'm like, oh,
stuff is about to hit the fan. But if we want to get this bar out of the red, then we need all we can get from John. Screaming, yelling, slapping, spanking, whatever John wants, we want it.
Okay, let's go back in the kitchen. Let's see what happens when this order comes up.
You got a burger, chicken, two codfathers.
I want to see how long this takes. Watch the raw meat all over her hands. Watch the raw meat now in with the chicken. She rinses her hand. She does not wash it. I just want you to understand the level of the cross-contamination and how we get people sick. Is there still raw chicken all over her hand?
Most definitely, and it's also on that towel.
Now she's now grabbing quesadilla out of the plastic bag. There's now raw chicken on that quesadilla, correct? Now she's got the raw chicken all over her handle of the fryer, doesn't she? Now, has Doug told her to put a glove on?
No.
Has Doug noticed any of this?
I'm hungry.
So we're at 10, 11 minutes. Nothing is finished.
Doug, you want to come back here and help them get this together?
But this is legitimately taking a long time, right?
Their ticket timing's not going to be right. They don't have veg on. They don't have anything.
Watch your manager lead by example.
Same table, separate ticket.
Okay, his hands are on that now. So now he's touching the drawer handle. No gloves. Well, he's making a salad completely with his hands. She just picked up that raw piece of fish, put it down on the grill, wiped her hand on that towel, put it down there. So now we have raw chicken, raw beef, and raw salmon
all
over this area. Now look at her hands all over everything. This is unbelievable. So there's no system whatsoever. The worst offender was Doug.
Everybody listen to me. Doug, I watched you. You never washed your hands. You never put on a glove, correct? Correct?
Yes.
Does he know better?
He does know better.
And your hands are all over that, and now you're gonna go touch more raw food, and you know better. That's what gets me. Now you go make raw chicken, put it all over your hands, wipe for 30 seconds with this, throw it here, and now you're making a frickin' sandwich in that spot. How long have you been doing this?
Long time.
How much trouble is she in, Doug?
A lot.
Do you know she has no money? She might not make it through the frickin' week.
I don't want her to lose. I want her success.
Is this successful?
No.
Well, the revenues has gone down since you're here. You drive her kids because she can't drive herself, right?
Yes.
You help her in every way you can. You're a good friend, right?
Try.
Why are you f***ing her in here? Why? And you send her children's money out the door. What happens when she shuts down? You go get another job, and she's screwed. And it's on you, because you know better. Good friend. Good manager. How much more are you going to watch her lose, Doug? What the hell is the matter with you? I will not let you ruin her life. And this is ruining her life, Doug. Her life! I have three NFL players outside in that dining room from the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. I invited them here so that they'll talk about this place and help her get ahead. Take ownership. This is your failure tonight. We have to shut this down.
Let's go talk to them.
I wasn't really expecting John to yell at me. I don't like being demoralized and done, and that hurts. It hurts to hear.
Allie, Cam.
Hey.
Bo.
Howdy.
How are you guys? So you guys have been waiting here 31 minutes.
Yep.
Did you get any food?
No.
Got nothing. What would happen if word got out that Tampa Bay Buccaneers were hanging out here? What would happen?
People would come. In fact, they want to see them.
So we have a great opportunity here, don't we? And what did you do with that opportunity?
Fumbled it.
Fumbled it. You squandered it. You didn't even throw the ball. You failed. This is on you. I hope you guys will come back for me and see this place again and give them a chance after we fix it, because this is a great lady. It's got a lousy manager. Apologize to them.
Apologize, John. I hope you give us another shot and come back and we'll get this fixed.
Thank you guys for this.
Yep. Thank you guys.
Hi, this is Jon Taffer. Click here to subscribe to Paramount Network on YouTube for more Bar Rescue.